guys, welcome back. Today I'm going to be doing a review of my experience with the grocery delivery service CrowdCow. I'm going to be talking about my experience with my first delivery. I'm also going to be talking about a few things that I didn't necessarily know or think about before I placed my order that I think are good to know before you try out CrowdCow. So yeah, let's get into it. So first, I just want to say I do have a referral link that will give you, I believe, $25 off if you sign up for CrowdCow. So check that out. I'll put all the latest details down in the description box. Okay, so first, let's just talk about what CrowdCow is and kind of like what their niche is in the grocery delivery service world. Basically, CrowdCow is a meat delivery service. They focus on kind of high quality meats, fish, poultry, basically anything you could find in a deli is kind of like what they have at CrowdCow. You can either do a standalone purchase or sign up for their subscription service. Subscription service, there's a few benefits. The number one benefit is you do get 5% off your order if it's a recurring order. And then you also get free shipping over $99. So I placed my first order online. So I got a pretty wide range of items. I'll kind of show you what I got here, but I got some fish, poultry, I got lobster, I got some steaks, I got several different types of like packaged items or like more processed things. So I got some shrimp burgers, some salmon spread, some sausages, a pretty wide variety of things. I wanted to try out kind of a variety so I could come to you for this video with a bit more variety of the service. Basically how everything is delivered is it's all delivered frozen. I actually did not realize this when I originally was purchasing. I don't think they necessarily communicate this very well. Basically everything is delivered frozen and I had absolutely no problems with the delivery. I found that the delivery process was very good. The packaging, everything seemed very well insulated. I feel like it could have lasted a bit more time if I couldn't have picked it up right away. So that whole experience was really good. Now, in terms of the food, the taste, the quality, from what I could tell, it seemed like pretty good quality to me. There was nothing that seemed like bad or low quality or tasted bad or anything like that. From what I could tell, it tasted quite good. It tasted pretty good to me. I would say some standout items were the sausages were delicious. We really liked these shrimp patties that we got. Also, the salmon spread was delicious. My least favorite things, I would say, I actually didn't really love the steak. It had kind of like a weird taste to me that I don't really know. I think the reason for that is I want to say it's just based on like maybe the cows had like a healthier diet and it's just a different diet than I'm used to eating when I eat steak. I don't know. That's kind of my experience. Now I just have a few things that I want to talk about that I didn't necessarily realize at first that I think are just good to keep in mind and just things to think about. So let's get into these. So the first thing, as I mentioned, is everything is delivered frozen. It is, I feel like, marketed as more like fresh, but it's frozen. So keep that in mind. Another thing that I think is really cool on the positive side of things is you can actually shop by farm, which I didn't realize at first. So if you want to shop by just local farms to you, or you want to just look at like farms based in the US or something like that, you can filter for that and look through the farms individually, which I think is really cool. So yeah, that's the second thing. The third thing that's kind of a negative thing to keep in mind is they kind of advertise that everything is like super fresh, like it's farm to table, like it kind of gives you the vibes that everything is like really fresh, but that is not necessarily the case for everything. So we got these lobsters. The lobsters were picked or the package date was like 4 months ago, 4 months prior to our delivery. And that's, I don't know, I'm sure that's like totally standard when it comes to like packaged seafood like this, but I kind of got the impression that CrowdCow had more like fresh, like it wasn't, they weren't like storing a bunch of frozen items for months and months and months and then sending them out, but they are in fact doing that. So yeah, just keep that in mind. The next thing that I didn't necessarily realize is it is a combination of Crowd Cow branded things as well as like other brands. So we got these like shrimp patties or like shrimp burgers, and they're packaged in a pack like you would see at the grocery store in the freezer section. It's not like, it didn't feel like some sort of like small farm packaging. And I just want to point that out because I feel like, again, you kind of get the impression that you're getting like these small batch things that like are from these like small farms. And it may not be like that always. You may be getting some more like mass market things. So just think about that. And then finally, when you're shopping with Crowd Cow, you definitely want to make sure that you were looking carefully at the prices. I think the prices for some of the things were, I think, reasonable. Nothing was really cheap. You know, you are paying for like a premium type of product, but some of this stuff I feel like is pretty expensive. So you do need to like look carefully at the prices and just look at what you're buying. For example, we got this halibut. I wasn't paying attention to the portion sizes, but this was like $16 or $17 for literally this one piece of halibut that would serve like one person. So yeah, just pay attention to the prices. Again, if you do want to save some money, I also have my referral code, which I mentioned earlier. If you've ever tried Crowd Cow, I would love to know your thoughts. If you have any other questions, let me know. And yeah, that's it. Bye guys.